proper story's supposed to start at the beginning. Ain't so simple with this one. Now he is landed on a rock in the sky. He gets up, sets off for the Bastion, where everyone agreed to go in case of trouble. Ground forms up under his feet as if pointing the way. He don't stop to wonder why. Finds his lifelong friend just lying in the road. Well, it's a touching reunion. He sees what's left of the rippling walls, years of work undone in an instant, in the calamity. That a survivor? No, ma'am. It's a gas fella, forced out from underground. Kid pops him good. Fella got a piece of him, though. Kid just rages for a while. An old repeater falls out of the sky. Ain't a gift from the gods, but it'll have to do. Gotta hold her still to spin up the chamber. Kid's worked up quite a thirst by now, so that fountain looks real inviting. Sometimes you just need a drink. A school of squirts tunnels up around him. Must have fled here from the mines. He sets foot inside one of Celandia's famous watering holes. Inside's old Rondi, the bartender. The calamity got him before his drinking did. Then Kid finds his trusty shield. The security takes him for a petty thief. Special delivery, gas fellas. Windbags start turning up for last call. more squirts start coming out of the woodwork. A big old fella pops out in front of the kid. Them windbags are playing for keeps. Kid sees the way to the bastion out the window. It's a bit of a drop. He gets a good look at things on his way down. He lands on top of a breaker's bow, and it ain't broke. Kid spies a good perch for some target practice. Knows he should draw the string all the way back. The kid pockets a memento from a breaker, once the fastest man in the land. Good news is the emergency defenses still work. Bad news is they're aiming for the kid. Picks up a few pointers from a dusty old tome. He's a mighty fast learner. He finds the distillery, right next to the arsenal, tough part of town. One sip of the spirits in that distillery, and the kid'll feel like a new man. The arsenal's where the kid can pick the best tools for the job. Thank you. some of them squirts birthing like crazy in a couple of corn bins. That one was Maud, the tutor. Once taught the kid good manners. He never used them, though. An old ferry barge sends the kid on his way. Bastion's real close now. Takes a chunk of alloy. The smell of barley and spoiled blueberries fills the air. Scumbags. Kid maybe shouldn't have done what he just did. It puts him out of his misery. Finds the core to the wharf district. He steals the city's heart. Might as well. Kid has a feeling he better get a move on. The place is starting to fall. Thank you. poor kid took was the only thing making this particular rock stay afloat. Kid just keeps running. Down he goes. Down toward the Bastion. Now the kid sees something stranger still. His mind races. Did anybody else survive? Sure enough, he finds another. He finds me. We talk for a spell. There's a bit of the Bastion's power in that crest, enough to point the way to the cores. All I tell him is to set that core of his on the monument there, then watch. And just like that, the Bastion comes alive. Starts growing again, growing stronger. Kid's gotta put its power to good use. Now the Bastion can send him even farther into the wild unknown. Kid ponders what to build. Bastion's a place of peace, but we can hold our own if we have to. Ain't much kid can't handle with hammer and bow in hand. Kid don't know what's out there waiting for him. The skyway. Now the kid can ride the wind to distant lands. The Breakers used to come here for target practice. Used to play a little game. See who could bust the most targets in the fewest shots. He's focused. He's armed. And he's off. Shot just happens in a flash. We'll be right back. sound bad at all. He returns with some of the materials we need. Ain't always much to say. Kid ain't had enough of the Breaker's barracks. Takes practice, and a mighty strong bow helps too. downright solid performance. Now he lands at the intersection between bad and wrong. Ought to be a core down one of these twisted streets, but which one? He heads for the squirt steps. Won't be no field trip this time. Biggest dump in town. Scumbag Alley. Some scumbag still feeding off the city's own trash. And there he is. The oldest scumbag of them all. Gershel. Her calamity ain't done much for Gershel's sunny disposition. They always said old Gershel wouldn't go without a fight. So the path is gone for good, and his city crest won't bring it back. No core, no surprise. Like the gas fellas are hiding it from him. Up north is where the gas fella foreman used to live, tending to his flock. Gas fellas all dress alike. Kids wondering the same thing. And there it is, but it's locked down tight in an alloy cage. Blustery old foreman's keeping his fellas in check, almost like he's showboating for the crowd. Kid ain't ever seen an elephant squirt before. Hopes he'll never see one again. They say even the most rambunctious squirts can be tamed. No sign of the core here. At least the kid got something for his trouble. His gunbag can digest just about anything. Except for this, it's quick for slicing and light enough to throw. Them squirts just don't know when to quit. Squirts don't make the best of friends, but they can be useful in a pinch. And now there's a new marshal in town. He hears the whole place groan, but it's too tough to fall. Might as well check the other side streets before leaving this hole. He comes back, just like I knew he would. The core hums in his pack. The monument's calling for it. The windbags used to be all right. Then the calamity took the floor out from under him. Kid does it again. Only fair he decides what we build next. Bow and a machete, every bit as effective as the fancier stuff. A lot of things need fixing up in this world, and we can start right here. His lifelong friends looking fit to keep on fighting. With a good length of meat gut, that bow's like new again. Little Zolwood oil and that blade shines like a light. Picked up traces of other cores while the kid was out. In better days, the melting pot was sealed tighter than the skin on a squirt. Of all the plans to survive the calamity, it had to be stab weeds. There's a core, he figures it ought to be deeper down. He cuts down every stab weed like there's gonna be a prize for it. stuck inside one of those fancy cages. No breaking a cage like that, but the kid tries anyway. Gotta find a way to spring it open. Some of the stuff lying around is downright dangerous. Throws a switch. Now what could possibly go wrong? Quite a bit, as it turns out. The cage starts lifting from the core ever so slow. All Kid can do is wait. Shipments start falling in. Squirts more bad. Some spring to the kid's defense. Judging by the movement of the cage, it's gonna take a little while. Don't take kindly to his lovers. Even some gas fellas take his corner. Heard it pop that mean old foreman. At this rate, maybe 5 more minutes, maybe 30. Hard to tell. Squirts get real territorial around the core. Then a shipment of free samples shows up. It ain't all bad, as the kid finds some spices from the motherland, tax-free. One thing's for sure, that cage is awful heavy. I still remember the look on his face after that one. The old world's finished, but the new world's just getting started. Folks voyaged across the boundless sea to found Ceylandia. It was good living here for a while. Kid packs a special surprise in every one of those arrows. Turns out those old bones still have some spark in them. Makes time to sample spirits from my personal supply. Hearty punch is so zesty, it'll let you carry on through the worst of times. Windbag Ranch was built for gathering squirt extract in copious supply. Ain't nothing more healthful. Slippery little devils. Some folks showed up to make a fast buck, nothing but a knife. Other folks came to train them throwing arms. Place gets awful slick sometimes. Still others use the place to test their finest blades. Ha ha ha! cuts all of them down soon enough. Kid comes back from Windbag Ranch smelling good and ripe. I almost don't believe it when he says he passed the Breaker's challenge. Couples used to walk the sundown path. Kid ain't here for pleasure, though. Quick and careful is the only way to go. But then, somebody gets to the core before the kid. The floor starts giving way under the lightest step. A single panic squirt could bring the whole place down. So could a reckless kid, for that matter. Fragments of the old world rain from the sky. Stray valuables are lying everywhere. Kid thinks twice about risking his hide for him, though. exactly open to visitors no more. Security is all fired up. See, the path was intended for leisurely strolling and such. Not so much for noise and tomfoolery. Position. The calamity changed everything. Even where the wind blows. Well, if we mastered the winds in the old days, we could do it again. But the question is, could have taken the core. Well, ain't no survivor stole the thing. Scumbag ate it by mistake. Tough break. Unlike the kid, that core ain't coming back. Used to ship live munitions down the path. Find time to find them. He's wise to toss those things plenty far away. Gas fellas need some shut-eye from time to time. They get real cranky when you wake them up. Toil, kid keeps coming back to an overwhelming question. Who else could have survived the calamity? So he didn't find the core that time, but that ain't about to stop us. War machetes are so quick, you gotta keep a good grip on them. The dead welcome him with open arms. The calamity took everybody after all. Kid sees it plain, frozen faces all around. don't much care to see him. Not like this. These folks never saw the calamity coming, but someone did. Someone close. Someone who ain't like Mr. Beckley and his kindly wife. It was someone like him. Kid sees him there at game, in the flesh. It's a snag or two trying to get to him. He ain't about to stop, no matter what. He's got so many questions after all. Just ain't got time for answers. The Tundra brothers didn't make it. They never saw what it was like beyond the walls. Nor did the bird boy. Didn't make it. The Jawsons, they didn't make it. Grady Sr., Grady Jr., they didn't make it. But him, he survived. Kid finds proof enough that man ain't from around here. Just think, without that man, we wouldn't be here right now, would we? The Corps survived as well. Kid does what he has to do. And then, what do you say to a man who's seen too much? Kid hasn't a clue, but he says this. We have to go. Please. He's a proper gentleman, that man. His name is Zulf. No hiding, he's an Ura. Folks like him ain't never been a common sight in Ceylandia. He's relieved to see a living face or two. The kid and I introduce ourselves in kind. Both to him and to each other. for the first time. For Zolf, Ceylandia was like a second home. He's real worried about his first home, too. Far to the east. He was born in the Tazzle Terminals. The Ura sent him on a mission of peace to our city, and he's lived here ever since. We fought the Ura decades ago, but that was then. Things are different between us now. Come on, give the little tiger a break. Fetching fizz is like a mouthful of nails, but the benefits are worth it. Kid ain't finished here yet. That's why this place is coming together. That's why things are gonna be all right. Well, look what we have here. Kid can pay respect to the old world and earn it in kind. The Valediction. Just another one of my sketches. Nothing more. Words can't express what happened, but they're all I got. We tracked down a couple more cores near the edge of the city. There's Pith Orchard. Built in honor of the bull, and folks like Zolf, who pray to him. That cinder brick fort, where the marshals used to watch over the city. No use praying to the gods these days. No time for it either. Folks used to make pilgrimage here, pay their respects to Pith, the bull. Well, the gods are long gone now. And the Orchard Core is long gone too. Seems Pith ain't much of a watchdog. The gods don't care about trinkets, but the kid ain't no god. Pith stood for something once. Something real. In time, though, the bull stopped being a symbol and started being decoration. He couldn't even save his loyal subjects. Pith makes a decent scarecrow, at least. Then Pith lights up like a rodeo. Kid breaks him to bits. Must have been guarding that shrine. So what'll it be? Invoke the gods, or tell them off? Piv. Kid decides to press his luck. Well, if the gods are alive, they must be plenty sore. Kid ain't never seen windbags that quick. Maybe Pith put a scare in him. Gods ain't gonna catch you if you fall. Kid ain't about to sacrifice himself for the likes of Pith. Kid passes Pith's trial, and he's richer for it. Kid ain't found the core, but least he found Zulf's precious shrine. Pith Orchard places a dead end in more ways than one. Now we can build a shrine of our own, though I got some alternatives in mind. Zulf doesn't touch the thing. Says the god of commotion is no children's toy. The Ura feared the gods. We turned them into toys, put their faces on our walls. Huh? The accused always got a fair shake in Ceylandia. Some used to take the bullhead trial. Survive the trial without taking a scratch, you'd walk away a free man. Trial taught folks three things. First, a good defense is a good offense. Second, gotta always watch your back. Third, ain't no godlike bull up there gonna save you. step aside and let things go. Some folks wound up taking the coward's way out. The trial pushed many a man to his limits. Well, a kid always wanted to compete in the bullhead trial. There's only one way the Cinder Brick Fort. The hard way. Sure, the city marshals may be gone, but now the fort's crawling with windbags. They've been left to freeze or starve or face the kid. Windbags ain't much different from normal folks. All they want's a warm place to stay and a decent meal. Out of health tonics. Windbags can't use the martial supplies, but the kid sure can. As for the windbags, Cinderbrick gave them enough heat and metal to munch on for a while. Well, the fort ain't theirs by right. Can't blame them for wanting it, though. So many of those sorry things hold up inside that old fort. stash of grenades is there for him, but things get even worse. The windbags put the kid on notice. Secured his plane gone haywire. Windbags gummed up the works. Kid ain't afraid of getting burned. Trapped the kid in the middle of the force parade grounds. Then they bring out Glutus and Glandon and all their scumbag uncles. They got something to gain, and only their sorry hides to lose. Kid takes down Glutus. Maybe it was Glandon. The other big fella soon joins his brother, wherever they are now. Kid used to dream of getting a marshal's badge, but not like this. The Skyway's a welcome sight after all that. And now ain't nothing left for nobody down at Cinderbrick Fort. Kid shows up just as Ulf's telling me about his own journey to the city. Seems the only thing the Calamity saved for Zulf was a smoking pipe. Poor kid collapses after just one drag. The past. Only good thing ever come out of the past is history. catches up with the kid. Hardly had a moment's rest since all this started. Fair to say he's led a hard life. Supposing what he says in his sleep ain't no lie. He never knew his old man, but he had his mama to take care of. Frail thing with pure white hair like his. Having his mama's hair did the kid no favors while he was growing up, but he learned to hold his own out there. School ain't working out, so the kid signs up for a turn on the rippling walls. Make his mama some money. Thanks to folks like the kid, the walls kept Ceylandia safe from whatever's out there. The elements, the Ura. You name it. Once the kid done his time, he hurried on home. Turns out his mama's time was done too. The city had nothing for him. The money he'd been sending home was nowhere to be found, either. So what did the kid do? Why, he went right on back to the walls for another 5 years. In the history of Ceylandia, Out there, kid learned to fend for himself. Learned to build. Learned to break. In time, the kid earned good standing with the marshals. They trusted him to scout out farther than anybody. One night, on one of his expeditions, the ground beneath him shuddered, cracked, and split apart. He saw nothing where the world used to be. The calamity happened just like that. All the kid had to work with was his hammer and the clothes on his back. Through twisted streets, he ran with nothing but the city crest and an old stranger's voice to guide him. Finally arrived at Ceylandia's vaunted safe haven. He and no one else. But then, all he got was more thankless work from a man who ain't even asked his name. Sure, I may be the one who dreamt up the walls and the bastion, but the kid made him real, not me. We'll be right back. I'd like to say I'll never forget him, or what he's doing, what he's done. I surely would. The marshals seem like good men, he says. They treated him with dignity. Zolf brought his antique smoking pipe all the way from the terminals. To tune a scrap musket, you start with the barrel. Squirt cider will toughen you right up. Too bad about the musty aftertaste. Zolf's travels ain't much compared to what the kids had to go through for all this. Even since the Ura surrendered to us, the marshals kept a wary eye on him. Here, Kid takes fragments of the old world and makes them whole again. All it takes is some fragments, and the Bastion makes it good as new. I try to let the kid down gently. This is the Bastion, all right. Except no one else showed up. We could always see the stars. We just never could reach them, no matter how high we built. We all lost loved ones in the calamity, he says. I don't know how I'm gonna go on without mine. Zolf offers to help me plot the skyways for the kid. At least the calamity hasn't touched the stars, he says. Ain't never letting go of his old friend with a sturdy grip like that. The marshals learn to pack those shells full of fire. Kid's ready to get real personal with hammer and musket in hand. Kid takes another drag, goes out like a light. There's something you should know about the kid. But let me take it from the top. Catches up with the kid. Hardly had a moment's rest since all this started. Fair to say he's led a hard life. Supposing what he says in his sleep ain't no lie. He never knew his old man, but he had his mama to take care of. frail thing with pure white hair like his. His mama's hair did the kid no favors while he was growing up, but he learned to hold his own out there. School ain't working out, so the kid signs up for a turn on the rippling walls. Make his mama some money. Thanks to folks like the kid, the walls kept Ceylandia safe from whatever's out there. The elements, the Ura, you name it. Once the kid done his time, he hurried on home. Turns out his mama's time was done too. The city had nothing for him. The money he'd been sending home was nowhere to be found, neither. What was I saying? Anyway. So what'd the kid do? Why, he went right on back to the walls for another 5 years. In the history of Ceylandia, nobody's ever volunteered for a second shift on the walls. Out there, kid learned to fend for himself. Learn to build. Learn to break. In time, the kid earned good standing with the marshals. They trusted him to scout out farther than anybody. One night, on one of his expeditions, the ground beneath him shuddered, cracked, and split apart. He saw nothing where the world used to be. The calamity happened just like that. Wait, where was I? All the kid had to work with was his hammer and the clothes on his back. Through twisted streets, he ran with nothing but the city crest and an old stranger's voice to guide him. Finally arrived at Ceylandia's vaunted safe haven. He and no one else. That's the Langston River. Used to cut all the way to the wild. Think it was bad then. That's Zolwood Grove. A nice, quiet place to show a musket a good time. Ever felt a Zolwood gourd? Like picking up broken glass barehanded. At Zolwood Grove, marshals learn to make every shot count. The trick was to pop all those nasty gourds without wasting ammo. Most marshals didn't get far on their first few tries. Had to catch a bunch of those gourds in a single shot. Funny thing about muskets is they work best up close. It took a keen eye, not an itchy trigger finger. Kid takes a little personal time for just him and his favorite musket. Plenty of gourds to go around, even now. Marshals like to fine-tune their muskets to get better results. The orchard grew over so quick, the marshals made it worth clearing out. man who fell on his hindquarters in the grove wouldn't soon hear the end of it. best of the best to clear the course in just a few shots. Kid probably could have made himself marshal one day. The city's unwanted things all met their end in the yard. Folks who fouled up will do their time here, smashing things to bits. The quicker they worked, the sooner they could go. Folks learn to plant their feet and put their backs into it. Others would plot a course to navigate that sea of junk. Had to work real fast for the finest prize. Kid pays another visit to the scrapyard for old time's sake. Worked too slow, and all you got was a sore back. Folks invested their earnings to forge even better hammers. Always plenty there for smashing. Ever want to just smash things for a while? You know where to go.